covering the week's top tech stories with a slight Linux bias.
A vulnerability in Broadcom's cable modem firmware has left as many as 200 million home broadband gateways in Europe and potentially more worldwide at risk of remote hijacking. A vulnerable user would simply have to visit a website or even open an HTML file that contains malicious JavaScript. This code subsequently connects to the web server built into the vulnerable modem on the local network. The script then alters the contents of the modem's processor registers by overwriting the stack to redirect execution to malware smuggled in by the request. At that point, the code can attempt man-in-the-middle attack, which allows the hacker to gain access, for example, to potentially sensitive information sent to or from the user's internet connection. The miscreant can also use the exploit to manipulate the firmware, change DNS settings to redirect connections to web pages, and they can redirect to anything of their choosing. So no doubt phishing versions of every bank and social media site would be something that they would think of. They can snoop on traffic, launch distributed denial of service assaults, and more. In other words, this is a bad one. Once exploited, an attacker can use the modem to do pretty much anything they want. Broadcom says that the exploit code was patched last May, but it seems clear that the fix was not widely adopted by users. In their tests, the cable haunt team were able to compromise a large number of SageCom, Netgear, Technicolor, and Compal models, for instance. Since Broadcom chips are in many brands of routers and modems, it's important for you to make sure that your firmware is up to date so that you don't get compromised now that the exploit is known to hackers.